lined up for you in this bulletin. However, the focus is going to be on the situation in Kashmir. Well, now the BJP has hinted at how the PDP was against the anti-terror operations in Jammu and Kashmir. In fact, in their media briefing, which they just had right now a few minutes back, the BJP has said that political parties have compulsions in coalition government, because of which alliances were not carrying out anti-terror operations in the valley. Now, this is damning. So listen very closely to the allegations made by the BJP. But before that, let me go across to Pradeep, who's joining us from Jammu with the very latest on this. This is very damning, and this is something which has been speculated upon as one of the prime reasons as to why BJP decided to part ways with the PDP.
No doubt about that, because the PDP had been, in fact, pandering to the local sentiments, and they had been, in fact, trying to keep the park proxies and the terror-related elements in good humor. We have seen that how they had been dealing with stone pelters. There was never, ever any FIR against them. In fact, they lodged FIR against the armed force personnel. It was Major Aditya, whether it was Major Gogoi. But never, ever they had any FIR against the stone pelters. So that means they were very soft towards them. They were soft peddling. And that was one of the reasons that it was a big embarrassment for the BJP. And finally, they had to pull the plug and, in fact, end this coalition, because this coalition dharma was really becoming a headache for them and a big embarrassment for them. Everybody had been questioning, in fact, the nationalism which the BJP had been preaching for the last so many decades. So they said, is this the nationalism where you are surrendering before the PDP that was pandering to the local sentiments and that was trying to be very soft towards Pakistan and Pak proxies? And we have seen that how they have given amnesty to stone pelters. But now, once the coalition government is no more existing there, we have seen yesterday there was an encounter. Immediately, all the three Jaish e Mohammed terrorists, which included a Pakistan terror commander, he was also eliminated. Though certain people tried to obstruct, but they were not allowed to do so, because commanders on ground has been sent a very clear message that in case of any provocation from other side, you need to deal with them strongly and give them a befitting reply. There should be a very strong retaliation. That means the policy of hot pursuit has once again started, so that once again they can reoccupy the space that was being taken back by the terrorists during the last 1 month, when there was a unilateral ceasefire. We saw that the terrorists had been calling shots. They had been looking for the soft targets. They had enough time, in fact, to plan their terror-related activities. But now, once again, the encounters have started. Three terrorists have been eliminated. And you can see the wording of, in fact, of the even Director General of Police. He said, three cheers. I am proud of you. That was the tweet from, in fact, the Director General of Police earlier. Because of the political pressure, he too was not able to speak that way. Because obviously, being a Director General of Police, he cannot say something while the Home Ministry is being dealt by the person who is the chief minister of the state. So now the winds of change have started blowing. Operations are being carried out. They are tightening the noose against the overground workers. Besides this, there's going to be at 2:30, there will be a meeting which will be chaired by Governor NN Vora. All the senior paramilitary force and security force, as well as police officials, will be present there. And during that meeting, the message will be sent to them to ensure that there's secure Amarnath pilgrimage. There should be no untoward incident, because already there are terror inputs. The terrorists will try to carry out certain attacks, so they are being sent a clear message that no such incident should take place and pilgrimage should be very peaceful in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Obviously, there is a change in the total paradigm shift in the security strategy also. From where one moment we had shackled their hands, once again they are free to carry out operations.
That you heard from Ravinder Rana at this moment, very categorically stating that it depends whether they will further go ahead with any coalition or not. But at this moment, their priority seems to be to ensure that law and order situation continues to prevail here in Jammu and Kashmir. For Times Now, this is Mohit Sharma with Virajan Saram.
Well, there you just heard a report which has been filed by Mohit Sharma. Now, Mohit Sharma was right there where the BJP Jammu and Kashmir unit held a press conference, where in unequivocal terms, they essentially said that the PDP was holding us back. That essentially that the PDP was holding back the anti-terror operations in Jammu and Kashmir.